What's up, HRV? I'm Zach Marble.
And I'm Ana Isalise. Welcome to What's Up, our weekly show about what's going on at the high school.
Congratulations to Abby Loyal for winning the Golden Ticket Award by getting the most Eagle shoutouts. She won a free yearbook, a free prom ticket, and all sorts of other cool prizes.
Other winners were Emily Leary, Melody Lacino, and Simon Hayden. If you haven't noticed, we've had quite a few snow days lately.
We talked to Mr. Polkinghorne about the schedule changes that will need to happen to make up for some of these days, along with the people's reactions on Twitter.
We know that the school district got a lot of backlash from which days they chose the snow days. Do you think they made the right decision?
Yeah, I think that's a tough call, because looking in hindsight, it's easier to kind of second guess the decision that is being made. And, you know, when I've talked to Superintendent Goldman about snow days, you know, it's really about making the best decision with the best information you have at the moment. I think that the two kind of questionable things that happened were, you know, in the midst of that kind of week-long snowstorm in February, you know, calling a two-hour late start in the evening, and then the morning we wound up canceling it. But that two-hour late start caused a lot of, like, people got upset about that. Could it have been, like, we're right now saying it's going to be a two-hour late start, but we may change that to a cancellation just depending on the road conditions and the weather. That might have been better, but it's easy to look back on and make different choices, you know. So, yeah, I think generally the right decisions were made. Like last week, there was an on-time start that maybe shouldn't have been a two-hour late start. But again, it's easy to second-guess those things. You know, with snow days, it's always the parents' choice, you know, to send their students to school. You know, if the parents don't feel like the road conditions are safe, they can decide to not send their student to school. But if the transportation director, who meets with the road crews, the county road crews, if they feel like it's safe to put buses on the road, then we're going to have school.
The decision of an extra week at the end of the year, how would that affect our school year?
Just means school's going to go longer. Really, what we have to look for in our in the school year is the state of Oregon requires a certain amount of instructional hours per grade. And so with 5 days missing of school, we were really close to not meeting our required number of instructional hours. So it's important that we want to maximize the learning opportunity for our students in our school district. So having as many days of school as we can and need to is important. So it won't change much for most grades, the junior, freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, besides getting out of school a week later, won't have an impact on them. It does affect our seniors in that they got out of 5 days of school, which is cool for them. It sucks for you guys. But the thing with seniors that we're really actually very tight on is the required hours for seniors. We don't have to move graduation, so that's good. That would be a nightmare for me to have to move it. So we're keeping graduation the same date as planned. We are, but we do have, like, I told Superintendent Goldman, like, we can't have any more two-hour late starts, because if we do, we're going to have to move graduation. I think we're good for now with the weather, and we're definitely good with seniors and graduation being on time.
What are your opinions on the heat towards Dan Goldman on Twitter?
I thought it was really unnecessary. Superintendent Goldman, you know, like we talked about earlier with the call for the weather, you know, related closures, like, you make the best decisions you can with the best information available at the time. And so, I felt it was unfortunate. I thought it was embarrassing, honestly, that our students would think it's okay to kind of target our superintendent and, cyberbully him effectively. I read through all the comments. Some of them were, like, kind of funny. Some of them are really rude and unnecessary. And so, I talked with Ms. Weisman, and I talked about, like, how we wanted to approach that with students. She addressed that in her classes with her leadership students about, you know, appropriate and inappropriate use of social media accounts, you know, in talking about, what's public and what's not public. And when you put things on your social media account, no matter how private you think your account is, it's not safe. Like, it's public information. And so when you're writing stuff like that, people see stuff like that, you know. And for me, it's a lesson, I hope, for students to know, like, as you get older, And as I'm a person that does a lot of hiring, it's totally normal for me to like go and check and see, like do some Facebook profile screening to see if these are people that are, you know, are not in line with our, you know, our school mission or vision. Like, so when you put hateful things out there, or mean things like that, like mean-spirited things like that, potential employers are going to see that, and they're not going to hire you. And college admissions officers are doing the same thing. And if they see that you're a hateful person or you're using your social media to cyberbully people, like that's not okay. Like social media can be really fun. You know, I have a social media account. I now have a fake social media account, which is flattering. And it can be fun. Like I love connecting with family and friends and that kind of, like just like probably you guys do too. But a lot of incidents of cyberbullying happen because people feel safe behind their computer screen and they say or write things that they would never ever say to someone to their face. And I think the same thing happened with that Twitter scandal or Twitter gate or whatever we want to call it. Like people were being really rude and saying things to Superintendent Goldman that they would never ever say to his face. And so I thought it was really uncalled for. I was embarrassed.
Congratulations to both the boys and the girls downhill ski teams winning state this year.
We talked to Erica Anderson to find out more.
10 seconds. You got this. So we had state last Thursday, Friday up at Mount Hood Meadows. There were probably 200 high school athletes up there. The girls and boys both did super well. The girls won the GS and slalom combined. The boys got fourth for GS and slalom combined. And then Hood River Valley High School won the overall. And then for individuals, Josie Peterson won the slalom. Me speaking, Erica Anderson, I got fourth in the slalom. And Josie got second in the GS, I believe. And then boys, Nash Levy and Chris McKelvey both did super well individually also.
That's our show for the week. Thanks for watching.
We'll leave you with the question of the week. This week's crew asked, guess that state.
Come back next week and we'll tell you
what's up.
That was pretty good.
California. Do you think I'm dumb?
California. That's like California.
That would be California.
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 Florida.
Florida?
Florida.
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 Idaho.
Alabama.
Idaho.
Idaho.
Idaho?
I'm blanking out on the name of it. You want to skip it? Is that Odell? I think it's Odell, no?
Kansas? I don't know. No?
Kansas? That's not new.
Kentucky, South Carolina, Virginia,
Oregon?
One of the Dakotas. The south one. Nope, the north one.
Would that be North Carolina?
Indiana. Idaho.
So we got a major river, couple major rivers coming together in one spot, probably I can't even guess. Nebraska.
That might be Idaho. Did I already say that? Utah.
Indiana.
Listen, I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla.